Luxious. What is luxious? You're not sure what luxious is? Why would you say it's luxious?
I think the luxious is a word for something.
You think what?
Luxious.
Don't play with that, honey.
It's a word for something.
It's a word for something?
Yeah.
Luxious?
Yeah.
That car was very obnoxious. Did you hear it?
Yeah, but it's more like luxious.
And you don't know what it means, but I love your enthusiasm for the word. That's wonderful. Woo! Luxious. Joshua is luxious today. Are you sure it's not luscious or luxious?
Luxious.
Luxious. Okay. Everybody. So, vlog style day today. Doing a vlog. And I'm going to be talking about a couple of things. Talking about before diagnosis, early baby things happened with Joshua, things that we saw when he was little bitty, and then up to diagnosis 9 years later from diagnosis, and where he was 11 years ago, light years difference. What I wanted to start out with is to show you.
Pretty good, right?
Did you wash your hands? Did you wash your hands? Huh? Well, did you wash them? We'll just leave it there.
Hi, Lindale. I already have one.
You what?
I already have
one. Oh, well, why don't we... This one's got a little bit more in it. Why don't we leave this one and I'll take this one. Why? What is it? What's the difference? I don't understand. What's the difference?
Nope,
let me see.
No.
What?
No minion.
No minion. No minion? Oh, I got you. That's right. You did tell me that, didn't you? I'm so sorry. So the minion's got to go. Right?
Got to go upstairs.
Hey, I got a question for you. How come when mommy wears a shirt with a design on it, you can't eat? But when you wear a shirt with a design on it, you can eat.
Well, I don't focus on it. I focus on my food.
Well, why can't you do that when I'm wearing a shirt that you don't like?
Because I can look around and still see it, no matter
what. Oh, and you're not looking at your shirt because it's on you, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so as you can see, he can't, the design on the wet wipes, he has, sorry, my hair is having an issue here, has a problem with the wet wipe design, and I learned something new today about the shirt because I hadn't even thought about that with his shirt. Sorry, guys. I'm so sorry. I just actually cut my hair. Insert clip.
Has been doing.
Oh, guys, I just did it. I just, to me, that's a lot. So, yeah, did that today, too. Anyways, this is so much better than it used to be. I tell you, if you're struggling with issues like this, or let me back up, because I was going back to prior to his diagnosis when he was a baby. When Joshua was a baby, we had a lot of hard times with him, and I thought he was a colicky baby because he cried a lot, agitated very easy. My first son was his baby. If you had a child like that, you'd have 10 because he was extremely easy. So I had always heard, like, when I had my first son, people said, wow, you're so lucky he's not colicky and he doesn't cry. And so when I had Joshua and this happened, I figured he was colicky. And I actually had gone through school and got my bachelor's in psychology. So I was really self-aware of a lot of things that could happen in child development and so forth, and watching the markers that he would hit. And he was hitting his markers. So there was not a concern with anything but just thinking he was colicky and he was fussy. He had to spend some time in the hospital when he was first born because he wasn't eating. But he was hitting his markers. Like I said, he was hitting his markers. He was starting to speak, but he was always, always agitated, cried a lot. Things bothered him. I'd take him to the store, and just walking in the store, he would, distracted much over here with my little I'd walk into a store, and now I know that when I would walk into the store and you open the door, right, the bell would ding or sound will go off to let someone know you're entering, someone's entering or leaving the store. And that is probably what would agitate him going into a store, because I thought it was just taking him out. Going into a store was agitating him, and I actually stopped taking him out. It got so bad. I thought I didn't know how to handle him, and I was just not a good mom. If you are experiencing this, I'm not saying your child has autism. It means I can't diagnose that. I don't know anything about diagnosing that. I'm not claiming to. But if you do know your child is already has autism and been diagnosed, and you have, you know, things that are happening and they're not verbal, but you're noticing very agitated, screaming, crying, going out, bright lights, sounds, all these sensory things, right, that drive them to overreact and just scream and cry. So now I know. After diagnosis, it all made sense to me, and I realized what I needed to do. So I started my own therapy with him, and with things that I know through my education and working with him. And then as we got him into school, going into private school and therapies, helped so much. And now he is doing wonderfully, wonderful. So things are a lot better. If you're going through this, if you're having these issues, Joshua was almost nonverbal at the time when he was starting to speak and hitting his markers. He regressed back so bad that he wasn't even speaking. And And it gets so much better. It did for us. I can't say for anybody else's situation, but so comment below. I will definitely talk to you. I'd love to talk to you. I want to give a hope. And I think that us sharing with you guys and you guys sharing with us is the best way to do that. Let me know what you're going through, if you're going through something, or if you have autism. And if you're new to the channel, hey, thanks for checking us out. I have rambled enough. So there'll be another video coming up right after this tomorrow. So stay tuned and thanks for watching. Have a great night, guys. See you, bye. I can't close out because it's my phone and it's huge. So I will just do this.